Good morning, everyone. I'm again here with a new chapter, with a new day. I hope you all are doing very well and you have done with your first and second week. And you have done your assigned homework, home tasks, which were given to you people. Now in the third week, here we have two topics. One is conjunction and the second is noun. So noun is not very new for you, but this word is quite new for you people. So now, what is conjunction? It joins two sentences or words. Words. Okay, any joining word is called conjunction. Conjunction means joining word. For example, Ali is a teacher and he spent his time in school. So here I have two sentences. First sentence is Ali is a teacher, and the second sentence is he spent all his time in school. So where I used and to join these two sentences. Ali is a teacher and he spent his time in school. So here and is conjunction just because it joins two sentences. Okay, if I give you another example, Sarah is a girl and he is Sarah is a girl and she's the student of class 3. So here again I have two sentences. Sarah is a girl is one sentence and she studies in class 3 is second. Where I use and to use to join these two sentences. Again it is conjunction. If I say that Maryam is wearing pink dress but she likes blue color. Here I have again two sentences. One sentence is that Maryam is wearing pink dress. The next sentence is she likes blue color. So here I use word but to join these two sentences. So such kind of words which join one sentence with another is are called conjunctions, like but and many more. I have given you two examples, so you have to find out 5 more examples by yourself. Write the definition of conjunction in your copy with the examples. And the second word here we have noun. As you all know that any name, many words are called noun. In noun we have naming words. Nouns are naming words. So every name is a noun, whether it's a name of animals, whether it's a name of birds, whether it's a name of any other thing. So it comes under the category of noun. So what you have to do, you have to look at your surrounding. It's full of noun. You have to find out 15 nouns from your surrounding. Like as in my surrounding, I have chalk, I have dice, I have blackboard, I'm in classroom. So such kind of names you have to find out from your surrounding and write them in your copies and try to learn the definition with examples. Okay, it was all about the third week and here we have just two topics. You have to go through it, you have to write the definition and definitions with examples. And yeah, I hope you like it. It will help you to learn and to make more sentences. I will see you in the next lesson. Till then, I love you.